You mentioned Clapton earlier. Do you ever see him when he was with the Yardbirds at all?
Yeah, I've been there. Aaron Peter have been friends since the first day I met him. Through everything.
Went through the band and onto other things, you know. And,
they used to swap about with me.
Yeah.
I never got into the Yardbirds. I liked Blind Faith and all those.
Did you see that the Blind Faith?
I'm just a good friend.
Oh, well, I'm just saying it's best should thing I've got here.
Actually, I don't remember one of them yesterday, the Yardbirds on the radio, and I was coming down from Leeds, I just had a bit of terrible guitar solo on it, not very...
Quite a lot of their records were dreadfully produced, but I think this is, although Paul Samuel Smith used to think at the time, I mean, okay, now, at the time, he used to really think he was the hotshot producer. The records of the band, they just don't hold up the same sound to him.
They didn't have anything to do there. They're producing other fucking records.
Might just as well have.
I mean, you go to thing now, I guess it's going to be at the end of the wall.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a studio somewhere that 90 tracks. I mean, it's just the usual, because the mixing is like doing the record again. Mirror Sound in New York. We went to this thing, we did a Ronette session. And he used to have the most enormous band you've ever seen in your life. He had three pianos, three bass players, six trumpeters,
three saxophones. I mean, you've got to get
into it when I play like this. And they would all stand up bass. Two drummers.
It would be more three.
Everything was either three singers, everything. And we did this session, and it didn't. Then they did it. Now I work in the studio, I only work one night. A guy who plays synthesizers, drums, and all.
Yeah.
And then a load of them around. And of course, we used drum machines and everything. And he had this all enormous band. And I remember him sitting there and he's like Errol Stepton. Got a list and Teddy Boy clothes. What's that trumpet on? Oh shit, that one there. Then he'd say, We've forgotten something. And we were mixing for 8 hours. We only took 3 hours to do the session. I said, this is ridiculous. I said, we've been mixing for 12 hours, 8 hours. I said, it took 3 hours to do the session. But you used to do sessions in 3 hours slots. You're supposed to now with musicians, but now people go, I go to the studio and I just do the track all day. But in them days, you just used to do 3 hour sessions. And I said, well, these 12 tracks, we couldn't remember where everything was. Is it on that one, though? Now it's all written down. You've got special things to write it all on and everything. But in them days, they didn't thought about doing that yet. He's saying, where's the fucking trumpets? Oh, shit, where are they? You'd left them out again. You know, they used to like that big wall of sound. Everybody used to sit in the studio like that.
Disco, you used to say.
Let's listen to it. Disco. Mow, mow, mow. Fucking hell, all they can hear that down in Times Square.
Can I ask you a very, very hard question that I don't think you'll be able to answer?
You never know.
It goes back to 1963, your misery hit. Now, the guitar player, it sounds to me as if it could be Blackmore. Is there, you know, can you remember? Bert Whedon? I think so.
I know so.
You know so?
And you know why I know so?
Why do you know so?
It was the first song ever recorded of a Beatles song. The first record ever recorded of a Beatles song.
That's right. Yeah, it's a quiz question.
It was written, the song was written for Helen Shapiro, because we were on tour. She didn't like the song, so I said, look, I'll do it. That was before they were big. So I went into the studio and I did it. And it was... The publisher was Dick James, and the day I finished it was the day I took it into Dick James was the first day the Beatles went to number one with Please Please. No, not Please Please. Yeah,
Love Me Do.
The very first. Please Please was the first number one they had, and the day that they went through it in, because I remember taking the record in to him, and I said, look, this is that song I've done at the Beatles. And he had four sets of gold cufflinks, right, with Beatles on them. And he said, the boys are coming in a minute, so they'll want to hear it. He said, and I bought this thing because their record's got the number one, right? So I said, oh, great. Did you get me a set?